we had some timing issues. I was, in those days, would become permanent United States Attorney. That was an election year, 1988, when I was appointed.
Ronald Reagan. You were appointed under Reagan.
Under Reagan.
Was the Attorney General at the time?
It was Meese.
Meese, okay.
And that was the closing days of guys like Giuliani and pretty tough United States attorneys. So the I was appointed by the Attorney General and President, but the law said that if there wasn't a permanent U.S. attorney within 60 days, and there never would be during that election year, then the judges picked a permanent U.S. attorney who gets only removed by the President. So I went over to the chief judge and asked him who they were going to appoint, Judge King. And Judge King says, the judges will appoint you. And that would happen in September. So I went back, and of course there was an election in November. So I went back to the office and said, look, we have to file the first week of October because I will be the permanent U.S. attorney and the Justice Department alone can't do anything to remove me. The president could, but that's unlikely in an election year. So we're going to file in October, especially with George Bush, vice president, beating up on Michael Dukakis, governor of Massachusetts, for polluting Boston Harbor. And that's the way we timed it. And when I filed in early October, I got an immediate call and ordered to come immediately to the Justice Department. I was violating all kinds of rules and so forth, which I knew I wasn't, but you know.
So continue. Tell me that story. So you're. By the way, who was the chief judge at the time?
James Lawrence King.
James Lawrence King. All right,
you said the building now named after him. King Courthouse.
So you file this suit. You know it's going to land like a bomb exploded. Right?
Yes.
So tell me what happens. File the suit, and how soon before you get the call?
We construct the suit, base it entirely on state law, because the United States Attorney's Manual required you, if you were going to use the Clean Water Act, a federal law, to go through agency approvals and reviews. So I filed it strictly under state anti-pollution laws. I got a phone call, come up here immediately. I flew up there with my a civil division person who I worked with on the lawsuits, and met Mike Finley secretly at a Chinese restaurant in Washington before I had to walk over to the Justice Department, because we decided it was not good for him or me, but especially him, if he were to be seen meeting with me. So we talked about what to say and everything. So I went into the meeting, and they said, withdraw the lawsuit. They just said, you're out of control, use phrases like that, withdraw the lawsuit. And they weren't going to get it withdrawn any way you cut it, but they could have been a little more polite. You know, I got wounded in Vietnam, and there's no heroic message there except that, you know, I've been to the mountaintop, and a bunch of subordinate people in the Justice Department don't exactly overly impress me. So they said, you got to withdraw the lawsuit. You violated the U.S. Attorney's Manual. So I went along and said, well, what provision? I don't think so. What provision would that be? They couldn't find a provision. Oh, you filed under state law. You know, they didn't have the brains to even read the darn lawsuit. They just knew that publicity was good but bad for the Water Management District, the state of Florida. You know, inside the Beltway that circles Washington, D.C., those folks are all get along, go along. It's all compromise. You don't sue people. You know, it's like a mini State Department. We negotiate. We don't ever do anything. So they ordered me to withdraw it. And the civil division chief always told me it was her finest hour as chief of civil, just sitting there. And I said, well, look, I know one thing. The president can order me to withdraw it. And probably the attorney general, although the laws are not clear about that. But I know this about you guys in this room. None of you have the authority to order me to withdraw the lawsuit. So I'll tell you what I'll do. You get the president or the attorney general to order it withdrawn in writing, and I'll withdraw it. But I recommend that you talk to the vice president first, because he's beating up, those exact phrases, he's beating up in TV ads. Go home, watch a TV ad. Michael Dukakis is letting Boston Harbor be polluted while you are ordering he as vice president, are ordering a pollution lawsuit to save the Everglades to be withdrawn. And of course, if you order me to withdraw it, then you have no confidence in me as U.S. attorney. I resign as U.S. attorney, and I have to explain why. I have to explain that this administration doesn't want to save the Everglades. And they didn't have the courage to do that. Later, George Bush's finance chairman, when he was president, Alec Cortellis, talked to me about it. But that was the story there.
Who
Justice never liked me after that, main justice.
Where do you think the squeeze was coming from on them? Or was there a squeeze on them?
Oh, the squeeze was coming from Big Sugar. When the lawsuit was filed, the Water Management District hired Washington lawyers, spent a lot of money on who had inside political clout, supposedly, you know, these lobbying-type lawyers. And we survived that only because we had a good judge, a judge who just gave him a lecture about Civil Procedure 101. And but Big Sugar and the Water Management District, with its influence, was very much, they thought they were going to get it dropped. They just thought for sure it would be dropped. And finally, when we were in court the first time and they were going, these Washington lawyers were going around, the U.S. attorney, he didn't have any authority. He acted outside of his authority. He can't do this. There are thousands of jobs at stake. There's no way that remedies can be provided. Judge Hoover just sat there so quietly and said, I taught civil procedure myself, and it sounded like he was teaching civil procedure. Well, let me say this. As long as Mr. Lehtinen is sitting there as U.S. attorney, I don't have any issues with his authority. As long as what he pled, that the Everglades is being polluted and it violates the law, as long as, you know, he has to prove that later, but as long as those pleadings make sense. Now, did he misplead? Did he fail to argue in the pleading that the Everglades was being damaged? No, Your Honor. Did he cite any laws wrong? If what he said factually is true, they violate the law. And well, yes, Your Honor, but he didn't have authority, and Hoover put up his hand and said, that's all there is to it. Motion to dismiss denied. And that's when they finally got rid of their Washington lobbyists and started to take the lawsuit seriously.